was a little sort of bench, and I would sit, you know, and there was a mirror, and I would sit looking in the mirror, and there were all these little drawers with nice, interesting things in them. And so I would play with the cosmetics and the hair things and the perfume. And then the most favorite drawer was the drawer with the nail polish. Yep. And all those beautiful little bottles with all the colors in them. They were great. They were so much fun. And one of the little bottles, or several of the little bottles, were by a company named Duragloss, and they were little sort of long bottles with a white top with a fingernail on the top, and the fingernail was always painted with the color of the polish. And so I found this particularly lovely and so cute. And eventually, Duragloss was bought up by Charles Revson and became part of Revlon. But, excuse me, later on in school, I met somebody and I dated for a while. His name was Kenny Winarick. And I think his father or his grandfather, excuse me, actually owned Duragloss. So it, you know, one of those things, and you know, one of those things that you never expect to happen, and it happened. But the thing that really stuck with me about all of that was a color of the polish, and the name stuck with me all these years. And I was sent to London to work with some different writers and composers. And one of them was Anne Dudley, who is a very talented and credited score. You know, she's scored several films. The Full Monty, I think she got an Oscar for, and excuse me, The Crying Game and Les Miserables. And
Art of Noise.
Yes, she was one of the founding members of the Art of Noise. Thank you. Are you working for Wikipedia? Yeah. No, she's incredible. She has a very long list of credits. And when I went over there, I worked with her in her house, and she had just given birth. She had a brand new baby. So it was a particularly warm time. And So I wrote this song called Strike Me Pink.
Yeah.
Still come back for more. And they
So what if I